Shabbatah
Shalom, everybody.
Hey, brothers and sisters, seed of Abraham, by faith and through faith, we greet you all. We are Hebrew Readers Church. I am Brother Kasafo, and this is
Brother Zachariah.
We hope y'all have been enjoying this journey with us. For you all that are new to the videos and the lessons, we invite you, and we're glad Ahaya has put it in your heart to come commune with us. We encourage you all to watch the lessons, get on the website, check out the Laws of Yache's Church to get further understanding on laws and frequently asked questions and doctrines. And we also have the Bantu is Hebrew document that's being worked on and edited and getting perfected by Yache's grace.
It should be finished in about 2 or 3 days. So.
Yeah, willing, that document is going to really help those that are really interested in getting more understanding of the Hebrew language and how to say certain words in the actual ancient Hebrew, like brother, Ache, which is H251, or H269, which is sisters, Ache Uto, and things of that nature. You have to understand of Yache's name, Ahaya Ashere Ahaya, which is the father's name, and Ruaka Kwadoshi, which is the mother's name, whom we praise, our Alahayim, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So we hope this endeavor and our labor is not in vain, and that Yache be pleased with our works. Today we have some very important information to discuss. Understanding the prophecy of Iran versus America, this war that is to come. So we beseech you all to really get good understanding of what is coming to prepare. The last Hebrew Readers news segment, it was discussed that the war with Iran and America has officially started by them declaring each other as terrorist organizations. America is linking Iran to Al-Qaeda as a means to have legal right to attack them according to American laws that were implemented from the 9/11 American staged events that were blamed on Al-Qaeda. Ahaya has revealed that America will use Iran as a scapegoat for the cyber attack during the winter season and will be blamed on Iran. This is why they allowed the media to make such a big deal about Iran hacking their drones and landing it, and also hacking the command station for U.S. drones, in order to prep the people to believe that it is Iran who has the capabilities to stage such an attack, and thus will be considered the cause of the cyber attack to black out all electricity, banks, ATMs, and communications, which is truly America's means to subdue the American population. After the blackout, step by step, as these events ensue, the citizens of America will have everything taken from them to the point of depression, and then the war. Iran will hit Babylon first to wound her, after the people have been oppressed to the point of depression. Ahaya encourages his people of all nations that believe his word to come out of that place and don't partake in her fall. Isaiah chapter 13:17, please.
Behold, I will stir up the Medes against them, which shall not regard silver, and as for gold, they shall not delight in it.
Iran will take no deal, since America has shown its true colors by dropping from the JCPOA and imposing inhumane sanctions. Iran is coming to destroy. There's one thing on their mind.
They're trying to buy them now.
And it's not working.
Right. Like you can do North Korea or one of these other countries. You can't buy Iran.
Right. And it's in the prophecy, they're not regarding gold or silver. There's no price you can give them. All right? Let's look at Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 11, verse 13, and then verse 24 and verse 26.
All right. Jeremiah 51, 11. Make bright the arrows. Gather the shields. Ahaya hath raised up the spirit of the king of the Medes.
Says Ahaya put it in their heart to do what they're about to do, right?
For his device is against Babylon to destroy it.
Right.
Because it is the vengeance of Ahaya, the vengeance of his temple.
So this is Ahaya's will, that Iran come against America and shoot against her. Is Ahaya.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead.
Were you about to read, or were you going to say something?
I'm about to read.
Is Ahaya who put it in the mind of the Iranians to stock up missiles for his devices against America? This is all Ahaya. He has them doing this.
They're increasing purchasing uranium and everything now, right?
They're trying to get nuclear weapons together. They started back up their plant. They have a plant for some type of nuclear activity. They said they're going to start it back up on either the 8th or the 9th of this month.
Wow. So see how AHI is prospering. Even the thing where they shot down the drone for the U.S. here recently. Mm-hmm. That drone was supposed to be some top military device, right?
The drone was worth over 200 and something million or something like that.
And Iran had the technology to take it down.
Right, and they chose to take it down because there was a plane with 30 passengers on it that was with the intelligence drone. So they were able to spot the plane and also the drone, and they chose to take down the drone just to show that we have the capability of the intelligence.
See how AHI has prospered in Iran to fulfill his will. Even though Iran isn't quote-unquote as military technologically savvy as America, yet AHI gave him the technology because it's AHI's will. His will be done.
And you can see the wickedness of America too, because they sent that plane knowing that they wanted Iran to shoot the plane down. Like, they wanted Iran to detect the plane and not the drone, because the drone would have captured the footage.
It's sad. They were trying to do a false flag.
Right.
And they were going to let those people die for the sake of their gain.
Right.
All right. Can you read verse 13 of Jeremiah 51, please?
Sure.
13 and 24, please.
O thou that dwelleth upon many waters, abundant in treasures.
Speaking to America.
Thy end is come, and the measure of thy covetousness. Verse 24. And I will render unto Babylon and to all the inhabitants of Chaldea all their evil that they have done in Zion in your sight, saith Ahiah. And they shall not take of thee a stone for a corner, nor a stone for foundations, but thou shalt be desolate forever, saith Ahiah.
Everything built in America will crumble down. Isaiah chapter 13, verse 18 and 19, please.
Isaiah chapter 13, verse 18. Their bows also shall dash the young men to pieces.
Right. This is the Iranians.
And they shall have no pity on the fruit of the womb.
There's no deal. When the ram comes, they're taking everybody out.
Their eyes shall not spare children. And Babylon, the glory of kingdoms, and the beauty of the Chaldees' excellency, shall be as when Elohim overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah.
Now here, we know Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed by fire coming down from heaven.
And brimstone.
Right? Now, Iran is not the one that's going to destroy America by nuclear fire.
Right.
Iran is going to wound America, shoot at her, destroy her young men, dash her children, not spare women and all that it says. But when America gets destroyed as Sodom and Gomorrah, the scriptures show that it's actually the 10 horns. The original member states of the Western European Union that are the ones that are actually going to destroy America by nuclear fire to fulfill the prophecy that she shall be as Sodom and Gomorrah, completely burnt and desolate. Can you read Revelation chapter 17, verse 16 to 17, please?
Revelation chapter 17, verse 16. And the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire.
So scripturally, the 10 horns are going to burn her with fire. They are the ones that are going to do it. Continue.
For Elohim hath put in their hearts to fulfill his will.
And it's Ahiah's will that they're the ones that do it. So the concept or any teaching contrary to that is not according to the truth.
And to agree and give their kingdom unto the beast.
Right, and they're doing this all for the beast. They know exactly what they're doing. They've given themselves over to have their one world government. Continue.
Until the words of Elohim shall be fulfilled.
Right. Can you read Isaiah chapter 13, verse 1 and verse 5, please?
Isaiah chapter 13, verse 1. The burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see.
Right.
Verse 5. They come from a far country, from the end of heaven.
And the end of heaven, you go north, or that's the land of Japheth. That's Europe. This is where the 10 horns reside. Continue.
Even Ahiah and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land.
The weapons of his indignation are the nuclear weapons.
Right.
Because that's complete fire. It destroys everything there.
Right.
Right? Can you read Proverbs 16 and 4, please?
Sure. Ahiah hath made all things for himself.
All right. These are all his works. And remember, he said he put it in their hearts that his will may be fulfilled. Right? Continue.
Yea, even the wicked for the day of evil.
So even the wicked for the day of evil was made. Ahiah is showing that those weapons they created, he's letting them create it to destroy themselves.
Right.
Because the wrath of man shall praise him. Where they're having all these evil devices and thinking they're about to have this royal dominion, they're only setting up for their own demise.
Right?
Isaiah 54 and 16.
Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire.
So Ahiah is the one that even created the people that are doing the work to get these weapons together.
And that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy.
Even the weapons, they're the works of Ahiah. He's behind it all. He is the controller. He is Allah, and there is no other. Therefore, it is for our life to hearken unto his voice and prepare to leave that place. And those that are not in North America, prepare to get to the places in Isaiah chapter 11, verse 11. Please refer to the video, Where Do We Go After America, to know of those places in Isaiah chapter 11, verse 11, before the 1260 days are complete. From the time that the daily sacrifice is taken away, an abomination that maketh desolate set up.
Make no marvel that the whole world powers know and want this war to happen between Iran and America, because they know it's the beginning of it. That's why you have Britain holding the tankers that belongs to Iran, and also Saudi Arabia holding the tanker. They're making sure that Iran is boxed into a corner where they can't do any trading with oil, because oil is their main export. And if they can't do any trading on the seas, it's just going to put them to the brink of war, because everybody is abiding by the sanctions of America. So if they see the tankers of Iran out and about going, they're seizing them, literally leaving Iran with nothing else to do but to fight America. So everybody from Britain to Saudi Arabia to all these other countries that are part of it, they're all just going to force Iran's hand. So please take it into your prayers and really pray to Ahayy Elohim to give you understanding and keep your eyes open for the signs. So, May Ahayy have mercy. And may he continue to quicken us in the spirit and wisdom to understand that the time is coming.
It's about to be some tough times, man.
All right. Hope you enjoy your Shabbat. I hope you enjoy the lesson. May Ahayy be pleased, and praise Ahayy. All right, you all enjoy your Shabbat that day.
Praise Ahayy.